One of the main challenges in piezo computers is the proximity effect, which is caused by the interaction between different crystalline layers. Different materials have different physical properties. Any change in one layer will affect all the other layers. And here lies the main advantage of the silicon-based computer technologies. They are built from one single crystal wafer. We modify the electrical properties by creating n-type and p-type regions, but it is still one crystal and has the same crystalline structure. In piezo computers, different layers have different crystalline structures. For instance, looking at this unit cell in my initial proposal, I grew vanadium dioxide on top of a piezoelectric substrate. Each of these materials have different physical properties. Vanadium dioxide has a structural transition at about 68 degrees Celsius. It affects all the other layers, and we had to study these effects. The closest work was the proximity effects of vanadium dioxide on magnetic layers, and Dr. Ivan Schuller had a number of publications on the subject. My advisor, Dr. Gupta, was a close friend of Dr. Schuller, but he had some doubt on his work on proximity. So he suggested I repeat the experiments and see if it works the way it was reported. I repeated the experiments. Let me show you a PowerPoint of a report I presented in a group meeting at the time. I used these three papers of Dr. Schuller. A link to these papers is in the description box below this video. The structure I used is shown here. And these are some of the experimental results. The results of my experiments was similar to those reported in Dr. Schuller's papers, except that I identified the damping factor, which he had not reported. The next time I met with Dr. Schuller was at the APS meeting in New Orleans, Louisiana in 2017, and we discussed two subjects. First, we discussed some advanced experiments that we did not have instruments for at the University of Alabama. And he agreed to do a couple of experiments for us in the UCSD labs in California. Then I mentioned that we repeated his proximity experiments and we found the damping factor. He kind of agreed that it is possible to see some changes. We expected him to publish a correction paper and introduce the damping factor. This would undermine the merit of his previous works, but it was the right thing to do. The damping factor disqualified the proximity effect for applications that Dr. Schuller had suggested. The next year, I met with Dr. Schuller at the APS meeting in Los Angeles, California. He did not have any students working on the proximity effect anymore, and we did not discuss it further. Another right option was that I should have published my results. I had all the rights to do that. It was my discovery. But I had more than 10 other papers waiting for publication. There was an ownership dispute over the new computer technology. We had to resolve that first. Then the owner had the authority to decide which parts should be patented and which parts should be published in peer-reviewed journals. And there would be some parts to keep as trade secrets, as it is customary in industrial technologies. The University of Alabama delayed everything for the ownership dispute. Finally, I had to use the legal system, and I proved my ownership of the technology. Then the university stole the prototypes and the notebooks, which I explained in the previous videos. Anyways, the discovery of the damping factor has not yet been published. But as of now, I have the legal authority to disclose it publicly. So if anybody is interested in this topic, you're welcome to work on it and publish your results. Especially if you are a graduate student or a professor who follows this channel, you may define a PhD dissertation on the damping factor of the proximity effect. And if you need any further information, you can contact me. You can find my contact information on my YouTube channel. As silicon-based computer technology reaches its limits, the luxury of building the entire industry around a single element, silicon, is coming to an end. In the next endeavor, we need to work with complex heterostructures, which highlights the importance of proximity effects. We need a lot of academic and industrial research to understand every aspect of the proximity effects. I hope this video serves as an introduction and we can discuss it further later. Thank you for watching.